Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel, and I hope you're all doing well. In this video, I'm going to talk about how crypto is taxed both in the US and Canada. For Canada, how is crypto taxed by the CRA? And how do you properly report cryptocurrency when you file your taxes in Canada? For the US, I'll also talk about how cryptocurrency is taxed by the IRS, so you can also properly report your cryptocurrency. You can use the chapter feature on the bottom of this video to watch whatever section is applicable to your situation. And if you're new to the channel or you've seen my content before, do me one huge favor before we get started. Hit that like and subscribe button because it does two things. One, it lets me know to produce more content like this. And two, you don't miss out on future tax videos. First, let's start off with Canada. How is cryptocurrency taxed in Canada? The Canada Revenue Agency, the CRA, has issued guidance that Canadians are liable when it comes to cryptocurrency. Crypto is not considered to be a legal tender currency. Rather, it's treated as a commodity. Cryptocurrency in Canada is taxed in two different ways. One, either as a form of capital gains, or two, as a form of business income. And all this depends whether you treat your cryptocurrency activity as a business or not. And it's very important to make that distinction. Is your crypto activity a business or not? Because they will have different consequences and different reporting requirements, as you will learn throughout this video. So make sure you watch the full video so you can get the most out of cryptocurrency tax planning. If your crypto activity is considered to be business income, then it is 100% taxable in Canada. And on the flip side, if it's not considered to be business income, then only 50% of the capital gains are considered taxable. In this video, I'm going to highlight the key differences between the two. So when it comes to tax time, you can properly report your cryptocurrency activity. But if you need specific help and you're still not sure on how to account for your cryptocurrency activity and how to report your taxes, even after watching this video, then I highly recommend you seek a tax professional that can help guide you on your specific situation. What type of cryptocurrency transactions are considered taxable in Canada? The CRA states that a disposition or a sale of cryptocurrency results in taxable consequences. And here are some examples that lead to taxable events. Selling crypto for fiat currency, such as Canadian dollars. Trading crypto for crypto. Using crypto to buy goods or services. Making a sale or gift of crypto. How do you file taxes for the CRA during tax season? If your crypto activity is not considered to be business income, then you need to report your capital gains or capital losses on Schedule 3 of your tax return. Now, on the other hand, if your crypto activity is considered to be business income, then you need to fill out Schedule T2125, which stands for Statement of Business or Professional Activities. How do you track cryptocurrency transactions for tax purposes? Canadian crypto taxpayers are required to use the Adjusted Cost Basis Method, ACB, for capital gains calculation. This is also known as average cost. More specifically, the CRA states that the ACB is the cost of the property. And in the case of identical properties, you have to use the average cost of each property to determine the adjusted cost basis. Let's use an example to make more sense out of the CRA requirements. Let's say you've bought Bitcoin at various prices, and later you want to sell this Bitcoin. Your cost basis will be the average cost of acquisition for those Bitcoin purchases. This average cost basis is pooled per crypto asset, so each cryptocurrency you own will have its own average cost. How do you determine business income or capital gains? It's very important that you determine whether your income from selling or disposing of cryptocurrency is considered to be business income or capital gains. The way the CRA describes signs of business activity is when you carry on any activity for commercial reasons, with business-level planning and execution and the intention to show profit. The CRA also notes that if you are buying cryptocurrency with the intention to sell it for profit, it may be considered business income. But again, you have to take a holistic approach. Are you running a business around your crypto activity? Cryptocurrency mining and cryptocurrency trading are examples of cryptocurrency businesses, but be sure to consult with a tax professional as to what your situation is. And yes, cryptocurrency trading can be considered business income, especially if you meet this criteria. You carry on activity for commercial reasons and in a commercially viable way. You undertake activities in a business-like manner, such as preparing a business plan, acquiring capital assets or inventory. You promote your product or service. You show that you intended to make a profit even if you are unlikely to do so in the short term. So that's business income. Now let's take a look at the capital gain side of things. If you're trading crypto for personal or as a hobby, then only half the gain is considered taxable capital gain. Here's an example. Let's say you sold Bitcoin and made a $100 gain on this transaction. Only $50 will be considered to be taxable. In other words, you'll be taxed as if you only made a $50 gain. This is what taxable capital gain means. Only half the gain or profit is considered to be taxable. This taxable 50% of your crypto gain isn't added to your income and taxed at your marginal tax rate. I'm going to highlight a very key point here, as there can be a lot of confusion around this aspect. You're only being taxed on your investment gains, not on the entire market value of your crypto holdings. If you sold your crypto for less than the cost of acquisition or your ACV, then this results in a capital loss. Capital losses can only be used to offset other capital gains and cannot be used to reduce your income. If you don't have any gains to offset during the year or in the last 3 years, you can carry forward these capital losses to offset future capital gains. It's very important that you know the value of your cryptocurrency on the day you purchased it and the day you sold it in Canadian dollars in order to understand what amount is subject to capital gains tax. Tax on crypto mining. When it comes to crypto mining, the CRA describes mining as using computers to confirm cryptocurrency transactions via mathematical problems. The CRA acknowledges that crypto mining can be both a personal activity, such as a hobby, or a business activity. It depends on the case. Again, this is where you should consult your tax professional to determine what your specific situation is. Now that we've taken a look at all the tax consequences surrounding crypto activity, how do you grow your crypto investments tax-free? While you can't hold cryptocurrency directly in a TFSA or an RRSP, but you are interested in investing in crypto and sheltering your gains, there is one technical solution. You can buy an ETF that tracks the value of cryptocurrency using your brokerage account. And then you can hold this ETF in a tax-sheltered account, such as a TFSA, an RRSP, or even an RESP. There are now several crypto ETFs that you can buy in Canada, and you can buy them in Canadian dollars. The downside is that there are fees associated with these ETFs, such as MER ratios. And technically, if you own these ETFs, you don't own the crypto. So be sure to do your research before investing in these crypto ETFs. And if you've been following my channel and you've been following my stock trades and ETF trades, you'll know that I personally own a Bitcoin ETF and an Ethereum ETF, and I own them through my Wealthsimple Trade account. So if you'd like to learn more about these holdings, make sure you check out this video. So to summarize, cryptocurrency, when earned as income, is subject to tax. And at the end of the day, it is your responsibility as the individual earning that cryptocurrency income to understand what your tax obligation is and how to properly report that income on your tax return. As crypto becomes even more mainstream, the government may change the Income Tax Act and the income tax rules surrounding cryptocurrency and its use. But for now, it's not considered to be legal tender and therefore requires careful record keeping, especially for tax purposes. Let's take a look at the US and how is cryptocurrency taxed in the US? Bitcoin is a decentralized digital asset that offers investors more autonomy than many other investment options. But investing in it does not mean you are exempt from taxes. So you may have to give an IRS a piece of the profit you make on cryptocurrency. However, there's a way to lower your taxes or even pay no taxes when it comes to earnings from your cryptocurrency legally, as long as you meet the rules of long-term gains tax treatment. The IRS views Bitcoin as property instead of cash or currency. What this means is that you will have to pay capital gains taxes on your crypto investments, just like you would on the sale of stocks. And there are two types of capital gains taxes that you need to be aware of, long-term and short-term. If you hold your Bitcoin or other crypto investments for a year or less before selling it, then it's considered to be short-term capital gains. Your earnings will then be taxed at ordinary income tax rates, which can be anywhere between 10 to 37%. If you hold your crypto investments for more than a year, now you can really cut back on your tax bill because the rules around long-term capital gains is key to unlocking that 0% tax bracket when it comes to capital gains. But you have to pay very close attention to your holding period and keep tabs on your taxable income if you really want that 0% tax rate on long-term capital gains. Long-term capital gains is what grants you access to the 0%, 15%, and 20% tax brackets. To qualify for these favorable tax rates, you have to hold your crypto investments for over a year before selling them. Again, you also have to pay close attention to your income level. Let's take a look at an example. Let's say you're single and you have taxable income of $25,000 from wages and $15,000 in long-term capital gains from Bitcoin. In this scenario, you would be eligible to pay zero taxes on your Bitcoin profits because your income of $40,000 is less than the threshold for single filers. And once you cross that threshold, you get bumped up into the next tax bracket of 15%. So going back to my example, let's say now you have $20,000 of long-term gains from Bitcoin. The first $15,400 will be taxed at 0%, but the remaining $4,600 will be taxed at 15%. Now, obviously, you don't want to give up extra income just because you may have to pay a little bit of tax. Don't fall into that mindset. But if you have the option to choose when that income comes in, that's when you can get into some smart tax planning and save yourself some money. Take a look at this chart that shows you your 2021 long-term capital gains tax brackets for your filing status and the income threshold that would qualify you for the 0% tax bracket. Notice how married joint filers receive the largest income threshold, up to $80,800 in taxable income, to pay zero taxes on capital gains. Tax deductions make it a bit easier to land in that coveted 0% long-term capital gains bucket. For example, the standard deduction lets you reduce your taxable income. In 2021, a single person can make up to $12,550 before having to share a piece of your earnings with the IRS. A married couple, on the other hand, can claim a standard deduction of $25,100. Contributing to a traditional IRA or a 401k can also help reduce your taxable income so that more of your crypto gains can qualify for that lower tax rate. These deductions and long-term capital gains benefit also qualify for investments in the stock market. Stocks tend to be less volatile than Bitcoin and other crypto assets, and it's a great way to get started as an investor. In fact, here's my story of how I started with just $1,000, so make sure to check out that video. The stock market has a great track record when it comes to generating wealth for the long term. The key is to stay invested in the stock market, whether it's up or down, as long as you're consistently investing. But no matter what you choose to invest in, whether it's stocks, ETFs, or crypto in this case, make sure you understand the tax consequences around these assets. And if you need help, make sure you hire a tax professional that can help you with the strategies and tax planning. The secret to maximizing the incredible rewards from investing is to understand how you can reduce your expenses associated with investing. And taxes is one of the biggest expenses when it comes to investing. So knowing how to reduce your tax bill will go a long, long way, so that way you have more money in your pocket. So to summarize, cryptocurrency like Bitcoin is treated as property per the IRS. Every time you sell, trade, or exchange tokens into US dollars or other cryptocurrencies, there is a taxable event where you may have to pay some taxes if there is a gain. It's very important that you go through the items I covered in this video in great detail, so that way you can take advantage of that 0% long-term capital gains tax rate. The 0% tax rate will depend on your filing status, your annual income, and how long you hold onto that asset before selling it. And on a side note, crypto assets can also be donated to qualified charities to get a tax deduction. When you donate crypto assets that you've held on to for more than 12 months to a charity, you get a tax deduction. And this deduction is equal to the fair market value of the asset at the time of donation. And at the same time, you don't have to pay any taxes on the capital gains of the donated property. I'm sure that was a lot of information, and this video was meant to highlight the key aspects when it comes to filing taxes on your crypto investments, whether you're in Canada or in the US. Each country has a different method of taxing this digital asset, so it's very important that you understand all the rules around the taxation. And regardless of whatever country you're in, make sure you keep proper record keeping when it comes to buying, selling, or trading your crypto assets. And consult with a tax professional if you're not sure on how to treat your taxes for your cryptocurrency holdings, because paying a professional can actually help you save on taxes and the benefit of not having to deal with the CRA or the IRS multiple times. Thank you so much for watching. This channel would not exist without your love and your support. So please do me another huge favor. Check out the links in the description of this video. I have links to various discounts, sign-up bonuses, and links to my other content outside of YouTube. So please make sure you check out those links. Every click directly helps support the channel. Do you have questions for me? Feedback on this video, or maybe you have ideas on future content? I would love to hear your thoughts in the comment section. And while you're there, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button if you haven't already done so. That's it for now. I'll talk to you guys in the comment section.